Hey guys, today I'll be unboxing, assembling, and reviewing the TB3 from eMotimo. Now, this is a motion control device that is good for stop motion and time-lapse and things like that. Now, I'm pretty familiar with the time-lapse world, but I'm somewhat new to the motion controllers. This review will be perfect for those of you who are like me and just getting into these. So let's jump right in. Included in my demo package was a nice carrying case, external battery pack with a few cables and charging adapter. Inside the case was the camera cable that's specific to my camera model, mounting plate, wireless joystick remote, the main unit, AC adapter, a few tools, and the quick start guides. Everything was a little overwhelming at first with all the parts and pieces, but after setting up my first time, it was pretty easy after that. Overall, the unit is pretty light and good for travel. Many cables and accessories for you to potentially lose, but if you use the included carrying case, that should keep everything together. The external battery is 5.5 pounds, which is a little heavy if you're backpacking up a mountain, but probably worth it for the shot. Assembly is pretty straightforward with some important steps. First, attach the TB3 to your tripod. There's a 1/4-20 or 3/8 mounting hole on the bottom. Next, attach the loose cable dangling from the motor into the tilt motor port. Then I attached the PhotoMate camera plate to the TB3. The trick is you have to spin the worm gear by hand, tilting it backwards to open up access to screw in the mounting plate. Once secure, screw your camera onto the top of the plate. If you purchase one, attach the camera cable, which is specific to your camera, plugging it into the TB3 camera port and the other end into your camera. To power the TB3, you can either use the AC adapter and plug it straight into the wall, or if you're out on location, use the external 12-volt battery, which they say is good for 6 to 10 hours of shooting. When I first plugged in my unit, the LCD screen lit up but didn't show any text, and I could hear a slight whining sound from the motors. Now, full disclosure, this was a demo unit, so understandably so, it's been around the block a few times. Fortunately, the eMotimo customer service is awesome. I called them up and they walked me through it over the phone. I unscrewed the clear top with the included hex tool, pushed down on the top circuit board to make sure everything was seated well, and that did the trick. I was back up and running successfully in just a couple minutes. After powering on the device, if you have a wireless remote, press the S button and it'll sync it right up. To give you an idea how quick and easy it is to do a two-point move, I'll show you a quick example with my GoPro on top to capture the time lapse. First, select New Two-Point Move and point your camera at a starting position. Hit the C button to proceed and then point your camera at a position where you want to finish. You can hold down the C button to fly through the rest of the menus to quick start, or if you want finer control like I need here with the GoPro, I match my GoPro interval setting to the TB3 setting. If you have a camera cable attached to your DSLR, the TB3 will act as the intervalometer and fire the shutter for you. Just make sure your exposure settings are dialed in. If you want to do video shots with a pan or tilt move, the remote has fine precision and you can just barely inch that motor, which is really cool. Now, there's no free control mode. If you want to do that, you'll need to do so in the set a start end point prompt, but the TB3 performs at its best when the moves are programmed. Fortunately, there is a program video mode. You set your start and end points, and at the interval prompt, scroll down below the seconds and you'll see a video mode here, which will give you your video shot a continuous move. Now, I just found out that there's a new firmware update, number 109, coming out soon, and with it comes some exciting new features. First and finally, you can cancel a programmed move with the remote. The other major feature that I'm really excited about is the new continuous loop mode for video. It's like those parallax moves that you'd use for an interview B-cam, sliding back and forth while keeping your subject in the same position. Overall, the product quality seems really nice. I like the clear acrylic top to look through and see the brains inside. The motors make a cool and somewhat weird alien sound whenever they move, so if you're using this for video, clean audio might be an issue. The wireless remote is really slick, feels just like one of those nunchuck controllers for the Nintendo Wii. Very easily, you point and control your camera with the joystick, as well as navigating the menus the same way, which is pretty intuitive. I think the TB3 is a really powerful motion controller. You can pair it up with different third-party sliders and rigs and open up an endless world of time-lapse capture, stop-motion films, gigapanoramas, it can do HDR, bulb ramping, and a whole lot more. I'd love to see a more user-friendly interface and maybe even a touchscreen on the main unit someday. It'd also be cool to have it connect to my phone and via an app, have more easily accessed controls and settings, kind of like GoPro. In closing, the TB3 is a really cool motion controller. It'll allow you to capture some really neat and complex shots, and if you need lots of customization and third-party support, this is it. I hope this video was helpful. If so, hit that like button and subscribe for more camera equipment and tech videos like this. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.